Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So in my today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this basic smoky eye. Now there is a basic smoky eye and there is a halo smoky eye, but I would be covering that in a separate video. But I really wanted to go like in depth and step by step as to how to create this and why you use a particular shade and why you use that particular brushes. I'm going to be explaining you everything in this video, so don't miss anything and watch till the end. And also guys, just remember that initially you're just gonna be okay, and I was like that. I cannot even tell you how bad at blending I was, and if I get some pictures, I'll just put it up over here. But I was pathetic at blending, and I thought I was awesome at that time. I thought I was like wow, but over years, after practicing so much, this is where I am. I still feel I'm not perfect, so you will get there. You just have to take things slowly. So without further ado, let's get on to the video. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel, and also hit that bell icon so you get notified every time I upload a video. Okay, so first starting off, I'm going to be using a base for my eyes. Now basically you use this base for your eyes so that when you apply the eyeshadows, there is something for your eyeshadows to stick on to. And also think about it this way: when you paint your wall, you do apply a first primer, and then is when you actually go and apply your paint, right? So exactly that way you want to like prime your eyelid so that your eyeshadows stick to it very well. There can be three different types of eye primers that you can use. One is something like the soft ochre paint pot, or you can use like just an eye primer that is specifically for your eyes, or you can use a concealer like this, which is basically your skin tone. Basically I have pigmentation around my eyes, so I'm going to be using something like this so that it works on covering my hyperpigmentation, and at the same time it also works as an eye primer. So I'm just going to be using this for my eyes. So just a little bit goes a long way, so you do not need to apply tons of eyeshadow primer on your eyelids. And I'm just going to be using my fingers. You can use a brush as well. So you see how instantly it covered my hyperpigmentation, as opposed to this eye, it still has some hyperpigmentation darkness around my eye. I'm going to be using a brush for this side and showing you. So now once I'm done with my base, I'm going to apply a powder right on top of this. If you apply an eyeshadow right on top of this, it is just going to keep moving and it's going to be very patchy. And trust me, I've done it a million times before I actually learned how to blend my eyeshadows, and I've just learned through my mistakes. So what you want to do is either take a bone color. A bone color is something that is close to your skin tone. You could also use a setting powder like the Sasha Baraka powder. It is excellent. You could use that because you want your eyeshadows to blend in very easily. So this is Silk Cream. This is something that is close to my lid color, okay, or my skin color. So basically take something that's close to your skin tone and apply it right on top of this. I'm just using the same Real Techniques Deluxe crease brush. So now whenever you take a shade like this, you always want to dust off the excess, because you don't want it to like kind of just plop on your eyes, and when that happens, it's just going to be very uneven, and then blending is really going to be tough. You do not want to like close your eyes completely, because when I open up my eyeshadows, they won't be seen at all. So I want to make sure I keep my mirror right in front of me. So I'm just going to go and apply it right on top of that to set my base. Also, using a base like this is just going to pop your eyeshadows very well. Some people do tend to have oily eyelids, so when you apply a base, your eyeshadows won't crease, okay? So now that I've powdered my base, I'm going to be moving on to something called as a transition shade, okay? So what is a transition shade? Basically, you want your eyeshadows to kind of have a very smooth gradient, right? So always try to work top to bottom rather than bottom to top. So basically try to apply like the lightest color on top and then keep moving down to the darkest color over here, okay? So now to use a transition shade, I'm going to be using something like this. This is called as the fluffy blending brush. Basically what this does is it's going to help you in even blending, and it's kind of going to help you in moving your eyeshadows easily. Also, another thing, when you hold your brushes, Do not try to hold it here. Try to hold it over here. This is more like for a very like maybe under the eyeshadows or something. But you don't want to use something like this kind of a grip for blending, because you really want to have a very soft kind of hold rather than like a rigid hold over here, because this kind of allows your eyeshadows to flow in freely. Okay, I'm going to be taking this shade called as MFEO, and I'm going to be applying it right on top above my crease. Okay, so just hold it right here and then just move in. And you want to start from here, never start from here, because you know you're gonna have a lot of pigmentation around here and then blending is gonna be very tough. So you want to start from the corner of your eye and then move in. This is the windshield wiper motion, as I mentioned in all my videos. So move in and out, in and out. You can also go in like this, in and out. It's okay if you kind of get your eyeshadows down below, because anyway you're gonna have shadows to top on that, so that's okay. But this is your crease right here, right where your lid closes is your crease, so you want to keep it right above over here. Okay, so now the next one is going to be a little more darker on your outer corners. Okay, now for all the brushes, I've already made a video on that, so I'll list it all above over here for the eye and the face brushes, so you can go and check them out as to what brushes I'm using for my eyeshadows. Okay, so I'm going to move on to the next shade, and that's going to be a little more deeper shade, and that is this shade called Pura right here, and I'm going to put that on my outer corner, tapping off the excess. See that, how much it was? This is all you need, and I'm going to put that right in the corner over here in the outer V, and then blend it in. So you see, I'm going right over here, putting my maximum shade over here, and then I'm blending it in. So next I'm going to be taking this shade called as Roxanne over here. Now this is a very warm brown shade. Basically I'm going to be using that for my crease. So you see where my eyelid folds, that is exactly where your crease is, and this shade is basically going to bind your transition shade, your outer V shade, and your lid shade together. Okay, so I'm going to be taking a little bit of that, just a little bit, okay, on the same brush. So you don't need to use like 1001 brushes, just this brush is going to do your pretty much your entire eye. I'm going to tap off the excess, and then I'm going to be going right at the corner, and then with a very light hand blending it in. Keep going back and forth. You can also go this way, but I just like going this way, and then if needed I can go in a circular motion. Okay, so next I'm going to move on to my outer V, and we're going to focus right there. So I'm going to be taking a little deeper color, something like this, and a little contrast to my lid color that I'm going to be using, which I'll talk about it later. So I'm going to use either this one or something like this, or if you have a black, you can use a black one too, whatever you want. Basically the idea is from dark to lighter shade. Okay, you can use the same brush for your outer V, or you can also use something like the Morphe M411, and this will basically help in like working right on your outer corner. So you could use something like this. So I'm going to be taking the same brush, and I'm going to be using this shade right here called as Chip. I'm going to put that right on my outer corner. So all I'm doing is taking a little bit of that. Always make sure you tap off the excess. Okay, now go right in your outer corner over here, place it right there, and then slowly blend it in. Then keep going back and forth, back and forth. Do not worry about the outer corner shade coming onto your lid. That's okay, you're anyway gonna cover it, so it really doesn't matter. The right kind of brushes matter a lot, so make sure you take good quality brushes. You don't really have to go for a very high-end brush. A brush like this works as well. There are a lot of drugstore brushes as well. I really like the Real Techniques brush, and they pretty much have all the brushes, but I just like these Morphe brushes more, and they're affordable. So I actually these days like to kind of feather it out a little bit. If you want to, you can use like a sellotape right over here, and you can like tape it right here, or you could also use a business card. So basically you could use something like this, and then you could like blend it in, so you can like feather it out, and you can see that line. Okay, can you see that? I'm going to go in with this shade right here called as Obsessed, and I'm going to be putting that right on my lids. Okay, and I'm going to be only taking it till inner two-thirds of my lid, not past this. Okay, so I'm going to take this shade, and I'm going to spritz some e.l.f. mist and spray. Now it's optional, if you want to you can use it. I just like using it on all my shadows, and I'm going to do that. Just because you use it for shimmer shades, you want to make sure you don't use it for matte shades because it is going to be very blotchy. So I'm going to take this shade and I'm going to put it right over here. Start from here, the center of your lid, and take it down this way, okay? And then take it down this way. Then take it down. So basically you just want to pat it and pack your shadows over here, okay? And you do not want to go past your crease, okay? See, I intensify it a little more and you see how beautiful and how popping it is. So I'm going to go over here and take it right till this place right here, okay? What you're going to do next is just take the same blending brush that you took with nothing on it, literally nothing on it, and just try to go and blend it in. So basically just try to blend. Now if I think that I have lost some of it while blending, you can go back in and just pat it on your eyelids, okay? Now that I'm done with my entire face, let's move on to our lower lash line. So what I'm going to do is, you can take any darker shade, you can even take a shimmer shade, but I just prefer taking darker shades right here. I'm going to be taking this shade again called Chip, and I'm going to be putting it right in my lower lash line, okay? So you see that harsh line right there? You don't want to leave it out like that. You want to use a blending shade right here. So I'm going to be going in with this poorer color right here. I'm going to be just smoking out my lower lash line so that everything blends in very well. And it does not look as harsh as it does right now. Just blend it, keep blending it till you're satisfied. So now I'm just going to take my black coal and I'm going to put it in my lower lash line. You don't want to use your fingers right here because your finger marks would fall in over here if you have not set your under eyes. This is called as your waterline, and this inner rim right here is called as your tight line. So right now I'm going to tight line my eyes. So I'm just going to pull it up, tight line it. That's it. I know it looks a little intimidating at first, but with practice you will get better, okay? Now, if you leave it like this, there are chances that the black coal that you applied is going to bleed down. So you want to just go back in with this, with nothing. I'm not using any extra product on it. So you just want to go back and just, you know, kind of smudge it out a little bit, just so that it sets in, okay? You don't want that to kind of bleed down, okay? Now next, just to pop your eyes, I'm going to be taking a shimmer shade like this. You can literally take any shimmer shade. You can even take your highlighter. So any shade like this, I'm going to pick it up. I'm going to put this right underneath my brow bone area. You see this? The brow bone area right over here. Over there. There you go. You see that? How beautiful does it look? And then you want to blend it completely. Taking the same shimmer shade, I'm going to put that in my inner corner right here. So that's pretty much it. So yeah, that's about it, you guys. This is how you achieve a simple smoky eye, and you can literally like use any shade right here. Just know the basics and you will get there with a little bit of practice. And yeah, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Like my videos if you haven't. I really, really appreciate that. And follow me on my social media. And also, if you haven't checked my videos, what are you doing? Click right here. Click right here. Click right here. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. Until next time, bye-bye.